Saira, you had a really interesting, I'll put it that way, relationship with your dad that you now think helped form the person that you are today.
Yeah, I mean, we were talking about this in a way that, you know, what is my husband like with my daughter?
Yeah.
And as you know, I adopted Amara, and when I see Steve and Amara together, I can honestly tell you that it is the most beautiful, intense, beautiful daughter-father relationship. And I look at it, and I'm not jealous about it, but it just makes me think, I just didn't have that with my dad. And it's not because I don't think he wanted it, he just couldn't show it. He was an immigrant, came over here, and a long time afterwards, my mum told me that my dad was actually an alcoholic, and it was when I was born, the doctor said to him, if you don't stop, you're gonna just kill yourself. Mm. So what he did was just stop, and my life, as a consequence of that happening, was all the guilt, all the shame, all the stuff that he felt bad about himself was put onto me. So he was really strict. Nothing was ever good enough. Really high standards that I could never achieve. So I always felt that I was failing. But on the upside, it made me the person that I am today. I'm pretty strong, I'm ambitious. Mm. I've been successful in parts of my life. And I went to therapy and counselling because what I found as an adult, as a mother, was I was actually repeating that behaviour on my own children.
Oh, really? You hadn't gone the other way, like, the less strict with your
kids? I hadn't gone the other way. Oh. And I just remember...
So what made you realise that, though? What made you go to therapy?
Because my husband said to me, you know, when there were moments when, for, let's say, kids' homework, I'd be like, why aren't you doing that? You've got to do that. Put more effort in. And it was constant. Yeah. It's all I knew. Because I thought that's what you do to become successful.
And I can remember when you went to therapy, I remember that you were talking to me personally about it, and you were saying it was a trait you didn't recognise in that you were doing in yourself. It wasn't until it was sort of properly pointed out that you realised, oh, my goodness, I'm completely repeating the behaviour of
the
my dad.
The biggest thing that I found by talking to somebody else was actually acknowledging that whilst I love my dad, there were things that my dad did that were wrong. It's very hard to admit that when you love somebody. Mm-hmm. And it was kind of that relationship where there were moments where I just said, Dad, I remember as a child just thinking, why are you doing this to us? Why are you doing that? Why are you doing that? But also thinking, you're my dad and I really love you and he did everything for us. So it was really complex.
I guess that's kind of the tragedy, isn't it? Mm. Because children, and even now as older children, you have that unconditional love.
Because your dad was obviously a very strong force in your life. He's your manager as well.
Yeah, yeah. So we were all working from, you know, from being children. He was very all the way up to when he got ill, really, and couldn't be there anymore. But he was very... very controlling of my eldest sisters. I think by the time he got to me, because I was the sixth girl, he couldn't be bothered. and that's the result. But so, yeah, he was a very, very strong force within our lives. But he did things. He was very strict. And he did things like... one thing that stands out in my mind is... and I must have only been four or five, and Linda and Bernie were having a fight. We shared a room, and Linda and Bernie were having this fight. They were always fighting. And he walked in. It was about 2 a.m. And I remember him saying, because of you two, I'm going to have to smack her now as well. And I got a battering. And I always remember it wasn't the hurt or the sting of the hit. It was that thing of...
injustice.
That's
of
just
it.
So unfair. And I think it just stayed with me. And then when I became a parent, I remember thinking, I don't want to do anything to my children that isn't fair.
So you went the other way.
Yeah. Now, I don't mean I let them away with murder, but I would explain something. You know, if they were going to be grounded or if they were told off, I'd explain why. I wouldn't just go, because I'm the adult and children should be seen and not heard, which is what we got all the time. Mm-hmm. But on the other hand, I had a fantastic relationship as well. He was a brilliant listener.
So how did you feel when he died?
Well, sad, obviously, it was my dad, but also I was going... it was just at the stage when me and Shane were going through our divorce and things like that, so I think I was so wrapped up in all of that that through my counselling, I remember saying to the counsellor, I feel like I'm crying about the end of my marriage and not my dad dying. And she said, that's because your dad's got... the brain's brilliant. Mm. And she said, because your dad's gone, so your brain's gone, OK, we can deal with that later, but this is now. So I had a bit of guilt over that. But I absolutely, my dad had many faults.
Do you know what's so interesting, listening to your stories, is although your dads both behaved in ways that weren't ideal, you're prefixing everything with, but I loved him, but I loved him. And none of you here have fathers. Mm. I mean, Jane, you've never had a father figure.
I've never had a dad, no. So, I mean, when I look at my daughter's relationship with her dad, they're so close. It's like you were saying about Steve and Amara. It's like I look and I think, if I'd had a relationship like that, then I probably would think, yes, I've really missed out. But I've never felt that I've missed out because a lot of, you know, my friends had very tricky relationships with their fathers, and sometimes I look and hear the stories and I think I was better off without one because I just became, you know, I had a very strong mother and I still do, thank goodness.
But what's interesting is you haven't gone looking for a father figure, which a lot of women
No, I was almost the opposite when I was younger and dating. It was just like, if you're not adding anything to my life, bye-bye.
Yeah.
I don't need, you know. So it took quite a strong man in my husband to kind of break through that, that sort of, like, tough exterior. Mm.